motion to go into executive session.
I make that motion.
The proper move?
Second.
And second, all in favor, say aye.
Excuse me. What is the purpose of the executive session?
We're gonna discuss a legal matter.
Of what?
A legal matter.
All in favor?
Aye.
All in favor, say aye.
Billy and Charlie.
Hey, I'd like to move that we come out of executive session.
The proper move?
Second.
Second, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Oppose? The record reflects their unanimous. Item one on the agenda, public hearing, public comment. That's item number two. Anyone having a desire to discuss any item that is on the agenda may do so at this time. An individual that hasn't, would like to discuss any item on the agenda, you may do so at this time. You have 2 minutes to speak. Going once, going twice. Yes, sir.
In reference to number six, item number six, adoption of ordinance number 983, water rate increase.
Right.
How much is the increase, proposed increase, and when would that take effect?
We're gonna move the item number five and number six. We're gonna move it down to 18, and we're going to have a continuation meeting until Wednesday.
Okay.
And then take up.
And then take those up, okay.
Yeah, we'll have what's called adjourned meeting.
But he does, just to give people a chance. We do have a schedule of the water rate increase that you can present to it.
We do.
That's not gonna change.
Mike can answer your question. Maybe you wanna let.
Sure.
Oh, okay.
Can someone answer his question, what's the increase gonna be for?
It's all in my paperwork.
Yes, it's in everybody's.
This one is in one.
It's in everybody's paper.
I can do that?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Does that answer your question?
I think so. And when would it go into effect? As soon as it's voted on?
30 days.
Oh, in September, okay, 30 days after? Okay. That does, thank you.
And the matter will be taken up Wednesday night.
Right, Wednesday.
So people can talk a little more.
Be aware of what's.
Yeah, what's coming up.
Okay.
Right, Rick, yes.
Moving to item number three. Approval of the minutes of July meeting.
There was an error. In the amendment to the agenda to introduce the ordinance 983, the minimum water rates under the residential outside city limits, it has first 20,000 gallons instead of 2,000. And then
there be any others?
Yeah, there's one more. I'll read it up here. said, where it says 20,000 gallons or part thereof and $3 per, that should be 1,000 gallons. Over 2,000. All of that one's in.
Is the lawyer one of the parents? This is just one, but I was kind of assuming that.
Yeah, Billy, did you give her that?
This is our ordinance. We don't have his, and I just knew that he.
It was a resolution. You put ordinance, it was a resolution.
It was an introduction of an ordinance at the last meeting and had the public hearing, and this will be the.
Well, it was an announcement that a resolution would be adopted tonight.
Right.
Now, you're looking at the water rates. You're not looking at.
Okay, that's what.
Yeah, you're not looking at the tax. Yeah, she just got it.
Oh.
I make a motion that we accept the minutes of July 18th with corrections to the amendment to amend the agenda to introduce ordinance number 90.
With the corrections.
With the corrections.
Who have a second? All in favor of said motion, say aye.
Aye.
Oppose? Let the record reflect that unanimously approved with the necessary corrections. RTS contract, what is that?
That's the one company that takes our.
Robles.
Sales tax.
Cash. Where does it go? Okay, we put it on, renew it either way.
Yes, you have to renew it on.
It wouldn't get some contract for the houses collecting plus those residential tax businesses.
Yes.
Well, are we going to renew? It's just a resolution.
Okay.
It's all right, you have the contract.
And the contract is.
Item number four, RDS contract renewal number 16-08-01.
What is that?
It is a renewal of the individual that collects our tax for businesses in town. something we've been doing now for the past 4 or 5 years. They do a real good job.
So moved.
Properly moved.
Second.
And second, all in favor, say aye.
My only concern is that the letter is addressed to Julia. I need to make sure that their record.
I'm sorry?
I said my only concern is that the letter is addressed to Julia. I need to make sure that it's, the record is replaced and that Charlotte is the city clerk.
So noted. All in favor, say aye. Opposed? Let the record reflect. Item number seven, Meyer Meyer.
Thank you, Mayor and Council. And I apologize that we don't have a whole lot of written reports or information this evening. We did have a bid opening for our 2015 street improvements this morning at 11 o'clock. So I've been here since 11 and I haven't had a chance to, or I didn't have a chance to print off much of that information. But before we get into the street improvements, the utility relocation portion of that, the notice to proceed date was today. The contractor is getting equipment and materials moved in, and he will be hitting the ground running Wednesday, so you'll start seeing some shovels hit dirt come this Wednesday, provided that the weather holds off for it. For the street improvements project, we did take bids this morning. We had really good turnout. We actually had five responsible bidders submit bids, and the low bid was D&J Construction Company, which they have done work for us in the city before. Their base bid was $667,721.00. We did break it up with three additional additive alternates this time around. The reason why we did that was we had $1,085,000 budgeted for this fiscal year in order for the street improvements project. As we were doing our preliminary pre-bid cost estimates, we realized we were going to run a little bit north of that. Now, we do have sufficient money to do all of the streets within the street account. It's just not budgeted to be used for this fiscal year, if that makes sense. Sends to the council, but basically what we've got is alternate number one, which will add Macon Street to the project, was a cost of $38,950. Alternate number two, which adds Davis Street and the loop around the park from the
40-some thousand.
From the tennis courts up to 40-some thousand. Elizabeth Street and from the ball field there, I believe it is. That is a $117,000 as a change adder. And then finally, the wastewater treatment plant access drive was also included in there as alternate number three, and that is approximately $43,000 adder. Essentially, in order to do the Davis Park, at the Davis Park loop, you would need to revise the budgeted amount by approximately $25,000. And to do to add the wastewater treatment plant as well as the Davis loop, you would need to revise the budgeted amount by approximately $75,000.
That's in total?
That's in total, yes, sir.
And your recommendation?
My recommendation is to, because the money is available in the street fund, to go ahead and do all of these included items, but I will leave it up to the council and the mayor what y'all prefer to do. We can award based on any one of these options. And I'll be happy to answer any questions y'all might have about any of those.
And you recommended that we amend the budget to
Good. Yes, sir, and I do, and I know that we don't have a resolution printed out for y'all tonight. I do have one prepared that whenever y'all decide what y'all want to vote, I'll read it off to y'all if y'all want me to, so that we'll have that on record, and then it'll just be actually executed in paper copy.
streets, to include all those streets in the project that he's proposed.
They're properly moved, and second, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Oppose? Let the record reflect that is unanimously approved.
Do you care if may care to read the resolution as well?
All right.
Whereas bids for the 2016 street improvements project have been received and read aloud, be it resolved that the mayor and city council of the city of Winnsboro, Louisiana, does hereby accept the lowest responsible responsive bid offered for the construction of this project by D&amp;J Construction Company, LLC, for the total base bid plus additive alternate number one, additive alternate number two, and additive alternate number three, items 1 through 21, in the amount of $863,250.00. Be it further resolved that said bids are accepted, subject to confirmation by the city's project engineers, Meyer, Meyer, McCraw, and Pixon, as to accuracy of said bids and the availability of city funds. Now, therefore, be it further resolved, the mayor is hereby authorized on behalf of the city to sign all contract documents required for the construction of the 2016 street improvements project. This resolution being submitted to a vote, the vote thereon was as follows. That's it. Thank y'all. If y'all have any questions about this project or any other projects we have going on within the city at this time.
Can we approve this report?
Yeah.
I think we lost track. We amended the budget, which has to be done by ordinance. So we need to introduce, we need to amend the agenda first to be able to amend, to introduce the ordinance, huh? To amend the agenda. And then we need to...
Are you sure it has to be by ordinance?
Well, the budget is passed by ordinance.
Doesn't necessarily mean, but I'm not disagreeing with you.
I'm pretty sure it does. I'm pretty sure.
But if we need to do it by ordinance...
If it's adopted by ordinance, it's gotta be...
But all you can do is introduce the ordinance.
That's correct. Y'all can still pass this resolution because it is contingent upon availability of city funds. So should that, for whatever reason, that amendment to the budget not pass, you can fall back on that. So, but we do, you are correct, we do need to modify the agenda in order to pass this, in order to introduce this resolution. And I guess it'd be 16-0802.
What was that on that?
The resolution is going to be 16-0802.
So we want to amend the agenda to introduce an ordinance to amend the agenda, not the agenda, the budget. Then we want to amend the agenda to introduce this, to adopt this resolution. I think that's...
What's the resolution here?
That was the document I just read for y'all. 16-0802 would be what it would be once y'all introduce it.
And then an ordinance to amend the budget.
And then apparently if y'all do need an ordinance to amend the budget, that would be...
We could do that the introduction of it and then adopt it next month. Once you introduce an ordinance, it has to be published. 30 days later, or the next council meeting, you adopt it after hearing that.
So you're definitely,
it'll be a public hearing.
We're going to amend the agenda.
you need a motion to amend the agenda first.
Yeah. Okay. I make a motion to amend the agenda to introduce a budget amendment for the street program.
All right.
Properly moved.
To amend the agenda.
To amend the agenda.
That takes all four of y'all to vote to do it.
Second.
All right, now.
Properly moved. And second, all in favor, say aye.
All right, now make your motion.
Now, I make a motion to introduce an ordinance amending the 2016-17 operating budget for the city of Winnsboro.
So that's what you want to do.
Operating budget, the whole operating budget.
Yes.
with Charlotte and make sure that that is what we need.
You wanted a resolution.
The resolution is what we need in order to, award to the.
Now we're going to amend the agenda.
Okay, for the resolution.
To adopt a resolution number 16-0802, accepting the bids on the 2016-17 street project.
Okay.
Second.
Okay, so second.
Probably moved in second.
Unanimous.
All in favor, say aye. Opposed? Let the record reflect that it unanimously approved.
To amend the budget, include that.
Now we're going to make a motion to.
Getting all that.
Adopt the resolution 16-0802.
Okay, we're there.
Second.
Probably moved in second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Record reflect that unanimously approved.
Thank y'all. I think that does it for me, but do y'all have any other questions or anything else while I'm here?
You've been fantastic.
Yes, please.
Come over here before you leave.
Airport manager's monthly report.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Previous month's fuel sales in July, we sold 887.94 gallons of fuel for a gross.
Is that mic on?
That, I don't see it. So fuel sales in July, we sold 887.94 gallons for a gross of $3,507.35. And we collected in hangar rent $1,150. We also are pending DOT approval with entering a contract with Meyer and Meyer. We finished our qualification selection process and they were selected. Do we have any questions?
Move we accept the report.
Second.
Properly moved and second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Let the record reflect that it unanimously approved.
Thanks.
Public Works monthly report.
Thank you, Mayor. Council.
You're welcome. Thank you.
We're continuing with our mowing as the weather allows us. We all know with these little showers in here and yonder, round about, it's kind of slows down some of that. We've got our boom tractor back. We're working on getting everything boomed, all our ditches and canals and everything taken care of. We've done some cleaning up out around the barn, hauled off some scrap iron that we had and all out there. Of course, we know that we had the rodeo parade this last month, and everything went good there. That morning, early before the parade off started, we had 18-wheeler turned over down here at the end of Loop Road, dumped catfish food everywhere, and they did a real good job cleaning that up, and we had to do a little bit more and put out some deodorizer to keep the odor down. And then this past weekend, we had the Rhythm and Rue. They changed the venue from on it to the old Hatfield Warehouse. And I think considering, I don't know exactly how many were there, but I think considering the weather and all, I think they had a pretty good turnout for that.
What's your pleasure? The public moves and second. All in favor, say aye. Opposed? Record reflect that it's unanimously approved. Code enforcement officer's monthly report.
Good evening, Mayor, City Council.
Good evening.
Mine is pretty short tonight. For the month of August, we have lots that have been mowed. Four. We have one house that's been demolitioned. It's going to be over on the corner of Ellis and 2nd Street. We also have submitted out two electric permits and one gas permit. Yes, sir.
Man, I don't know if this falls under your jurisdiction, but there are a couple of businesses in town that they're kind of like a flea market type thing,
And I got a phone call from one of them that is concerned with individuals that sets up, they set up tents and they sell purses and big rugs and things like that on parking lots, on people's parking lots. And the concern is that those individuals aren't paying their fair share. They're not getting their the permits that they need, not paying sales tax on the items that they sell. And I don't know if that falls under you, but if that's something that you may know about it, so you've probably done something. But anyway, I just wanted to kind of bring it to your attention that others are concerned about that.
Councilman Sherrod, it falls under my head. On that incident with that person, I thought, because it was on his private property, that he was allowing them to do that. But immediately when I found out that he wasn't allowing them to do that, then I went and exercised the right of the city by the ordinance and told them that they had to buy a peddler's license or close down and change to do business somewhere else. So therefore, they're not doing business. But those people that you do see on different parking lots, 10 out of 10, they have peddler's license. But on that day, that person did not. But I was under the notion that because they were there on his property, that he had gave him permission. But when I found out that he didn't, you know, they were asked to come and purchase license or quit selling.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
What is your pleasure?
I move that we accept the code enforcement officer's monthly report.
Second. Moved. Second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Let the record reflect that it's unanimously approved. Fire Chief monthly report.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mayor and Council. For the month of July, we had no structure or mobile home fires. We had 3 total vehicle fires, 1 in town, 2 out of district. City limits. We had 5 grass fire calls. All of them were out of town. We had 1 extrication down out of Gilbert. It was out of town. There was no machinery, apartments, motels, public assemblies, schools, hospitals, nursing home, business calls of any sort. We had 1 helicopter assist, 1 fire alarm here in town, and no storage or extra services or hazmat calls, mutual aid, or no smoke detectors installed, no fireworks or false alarms or anything else. That brings our call total 82 calls this month was 11 into through the department, 93 for the year. All our equipment inventory has been kept. We've been testing weather permit and few things. All the meetings, classes have been continuing, and we're trying to keep the station cleaned and get it painted, weather permitted, finished up. And that's it. If there's any questions. Yes, sir.
Thank you. What is your pleasure?
I make a motion to accept the fire chief monthly report.
Properly moved.
Second.
And second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Let the monthly report reflect that. Police chief monthly report.
Thank you, Mayor and Council. For the month of 7/18/16 through 8/14/16, on criminal charges, we had 35 total for the year, so forth, 297. Traffic charge for the month, we had 41 total for the year, 452. And our accidents, we had highway accidents, we had 15, parking lot was 9. The total was 24, and the cost of service, so forth, 648. That's all I have.
Thank you, Chief. What is your pleasure?
I move that we accept the police chief's monthly report.
Properly moved.
Second.
And second. All in favor say aye. Opposed? The record reflect that it's unanimously approved. Your main officer, Grant, Mr. Harris, would you please?
Thank you, Mayor and Council. You made off his monthly report for the month of August. We had
$1,000 street for the month, but a year 15, claim zero for the year 30. Foster, five for the year 31. Monroe, zero for the month, two for the year. Died and escaped, zero for the month, and seven for the year. Blue dogs picked up, eight for the year 93. Total care for the month is 39. Pounds of food, 650 pounds for the month, and 4,650 pounds for the year. Total dogs and pen, 31. Miscellaneous animals for the month, four. Total cost for the month, 99. Total dead animals within the city limits, 20. Total city ordinance, 27. Total dog bite, zero. Thank you.
You like copies?
I make a motion to accept the main officer report.
I second it.
Properly moved and second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Let the record reflect that unanimously approved. And I want to say that to the humane section, it's not too often that we get an opportunity to boast about what's going on up there. But the beautification program that you guys are involved in, it's really, really, really looks nice up there.
Thank you, Mayor.
Economic development.
Thank you, Mayor, City Council. I am certainly pleased to announce tonight that Franklin Rubber Resources, a subsidiary of One More Rubber Recycling, is in full operation. They are presently employed 15 people, operating three shifts at the present time. And they still have a lot of work that's going to be done at the location. They are getting prices and estimates right now on what it's going to cost for them to redo the roofs of the buildings. One building, 13,725 square feet, and the other one is 14,725 square feet. It will be re-roofed in its entirety. They are refurbishing and rebuilding all the equipment at the location. We still wait for some technical information through Attorney Singer and the mayor for us to close out that project to where it can be a lease or a contract between the town of Winsboro and Franklin Rubber Resources. And we anticipate that that should take place sometime this month.
Before the next council meeting.
Right, before the next council meeting. I think that is, there's been a lot of work and a lot of effort put into that. We have gotten a lot of people involved in it, and there's been a lot of work going on at that location, and they're excited about it. They are profitable. I will say that they said that their first month of full operation was a profitable month, and they're looking forward to for that business to continue to grow. Is there any questions you have about that? The next thing I'd like to bring you up to date on is our farmer's market. Our farmer's market, it has been funded. The contract has been prepared. and it should have been sent out Thursday or Friday of last week, but with the inclement weather that we've had, Mr. Eskew, who's with the Division of Administration, they closed everything down and they couldn't get it out. But as soon as they get back to where they're, they can operate in government at that location, we will have it. He's excited about the project, and it falls within the bid contracts that we have been awarded, and we're excited about that happening. And that's all I have. Any questions?
Billy, I want to commend you and our legal advice for the hard work that the two of you have put into bringing the rubber chip company back into existence. I know that you put a lot of work into it, both of you, and the end result has really showed up.
Well, thank you, Mayor. But it really is—it's a bit done all of our attorney, our legal department, and yourself that's done that. That's made it happen. They've worked very diligently with us, and you know, to make this happen. As you know, this was a company that was on the verge of just shutting down, and nothing happened. But it looks like it has a positive future for us. I'm excited about it. Thank you very much.
Thank you. What's your pleasure?
Make a motion we accept the economic development report.
Properly moved and second. All in favor say aye. Opposed? Let the record reflect that it's unanimously approved. Community Center monthly report.
Good evening. We had four events last month. One class reunion, two wedding and receptions, and a birthday.
Okay. What is your pleasure?
Make a motion to accept the second report.
Properly moved.
Second.
And second. All in favor say aye. Opposed? Yeah. Let your record reflect that it unanimously approved. Athletic director.
Mayor? If I may. Our athletic director is not here.
I'm sorry.
Okay. Mayor?
Yes.
Yeah. Since our athletic director is not here, I'd like to make a motion, and our Main Street director is here, I'd like to make a motion to amend the agenda and add Kayla Francis, put her at number 16.
Okay. Been properly moved.
Second.
And second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Let the record reflect that it unanimously approved.
Thank you. Been a busy spring. I think you'll see on your desk that I gave you a report of things that are coming up and put on your calendar, and we hope to be able to provide that in the future. We did our last chamber meeting was sort of a community report, and we were able to provide this, and it's just a good thing to have to know what's going on in the community as far as the chamber and Main Street and tourism are concerned. For Main Street, we hosted three workshops, two in fabric art, a social media workshop, and a calligraphy workshop. All of them were to their max. We co-hosted, along with the Chamber, the Main Street Market with the Chamber of Commerce in June, and had great business there, and a lot of vendors from in town and from out of town, a lot of food trucks from in town and out of town. We've hosted two receptions and a wedding at the museum. Most importantly, if you'll look on the very back of your events, we hosted last week a National Geographic magazine called us, along with Delta Regional Authority in North Delta, to co-host a meeting about a website regarding businesses, organizations, anyone who wants to be a part of the National Geographic website that's free of charge is asked to go to that website, to that particular site that I have listed there, and you're eligible to nominate your business, your organization, individuals, whatever you plan to do. If you have a website, you can become a part of this literally worldwide recognition and visibility. It's a huge deal. And they've been hosting these meetings across the state. And we at the Old Post Office Museum were asking to help with getting the word out with this. And so we did, and it's going to really be something. They're having an official launch and matches for the tricentennial in September 13th, I believe. So if you would go to that site, take a look at it. If you have a business or organization that you'd like for to be on that particular site, it's wide open to you. That's quite an opportunity. We've had four exhibits this year at the museum that have been very well received. The Friends and Neighbors with the Washita River Art Gallery, the Celebrating Local Sports, that was the Smithsonian and Louisiana Endowment for Humanities exhibit that was so well received. Color Explosion, the Fabric Art by Jane Hartfield, and who held two workshops for us. And then the next exhibit will open this coming Thursday evening from 5 to 7 with the reception at the museum. And it's called Wild Louisiana. It's a painter and a sculptor, both artists from New Orleans. The sculptor's work is in the works of Wetton Marcellus, in the collections of Wetton Marcellus, and Mary Tyler Moore, got a Bernadette Peters. It's really something to see. We have art hanging from the ceiling, on the walls, everywhere else. It's very interesting, a lot of fun, and sort of portrays a part of Louisiana that is sort of our spirit of life that we love so much. So if you get a chance to come to the opening this Thursday from 5 to 7, we'd love to see you. That exhibit runs through October 14th. The next exhibit will be, hopefully we'll have it open by November 12th, which will be the opening also of the Main Street, the next Main Street Market, in conjunction with the Chamber of Commerce, and that will of course be the Christmas exhibit. So, exciting news, we're about to have a new business open downtown, a catering business as well as a bakery behind what is now Painted Pony, where the grooming shop, pet grooming shop, used to be. Vicki Phillips is opening a catering business, and she'll also be providing not only bakery goods but casseroles for you to take home and that type of thing. And the name of it will be The Witchin Kitchen. So she has a site on Facebook, so please take a look and encourage her, and I'm sure a lot of us will support her efforts as well. I brought a signed copy of this year's Cooperative Endeavor Agreement to you, Mr. Mayor, and that was last year's, and was wondering what we needed to do to get our funding from the city for Main Street, and if there's anything further that I need to do for that, and also to get this year's signed. So if there are any questions or anything, I'd be happy to answer.
Mr. Friend, I don't have any questions. The agreement, I'd rather not do dirty laundry out in public, but I would be very much to speak with you terms of as to what the city's problem objection of paying of giving donating.
I wasn't aware that there was an objection.
Excuse me.
I wasn't aware that there was an objection. I came to see you a couple of weeks ago and asked you if there was a problem, and you said no, and we shook hands over it, and I had no idea there was a problem.
I didn't know that you were asking if there's a problem about our donating the funds. You know that we had an agreement, and I don't feel that the agreement was lived up to by the Main Street committee. Our agreement was that we would be allowed to sit in on meetings and be a part of the meeting. And
we've had
three
meeting,
three different times that we attended the meeting, and when the business, right after the meeting opening, it went into executive session, and the people that was representing the town was asked to leave. That is not my impression, agreement that we made. It was made that we would have open access to the meeting, and we did not.
Okay, I will inform my board of this. When we do have executive session, I'm asked to leave the room as well.
Excuse me?
I said when we go into executive session, I'm asked to leave the room as well, so I will bring this up to my board. I was not aware that that there was a problem. Mm-hmm. But I will certainly bring it up to my board, and I'll have them come to you and talk with you about it.
That's good. Okay. Okay. That's fine.
I move we accept the report.
Properly moved and second. All in favor, say aye. Opposed? Let the record reflect that it was unanimously approved. Finance report.
Mayor, on Thursday or Friday of last week, we received these financial reports on Wednesday, and I think it was on Friday that I texted Charlika, and she said that we would have a corrected copy by early this morning, which leads me to think that these are not correct. So I didn't spend a lot of time with you in a report that was not correct. So I think this too would have to be moved over to another time when we have correct financials.
She's requesting that the financial report be moved to another time.
She wants to table it.
Fine.
She wants to table it. That's a very good idea.
What was not there?
The actual issue is with the report that's printed out from Enhance that's put into QuickBooks regarding the water bills. With the water bills being so messed up, basically, and all the corrections and adjustments I had to do, it had to be pushed back until 8/3 that it was generated, actually. So at the time when I text you that, I was thinking I was correcting them and I needed to put it in then, but because the report was printed on 8/3, it's not going to show up to next month anyway.
And to explain exactly what was happening with the 10 meters. Philip, you want to explain this?
Let me ask this question right here. How have we got a bill that's $900,000.
He's fixing the plane right now.
Yeah. We have 10 meters in the ground that are, we call them new meters, that we've had to replace the register in the MIU on the electronic device on the meters. And these new ones register down to the tenth of a gallon. The old ones only register down to 10 gallons. Yeah. Having said that, that adds an extra digit onto the register, onto the readout. Well, when our computer was set up, it was set up to read for every 1,000 gallons. Well, this extra digit on there has put that point to a place where it's actually picking up the hundreds of gallons, not 1,000 gallons. We just recently, Charlotte and I discovered this problem. And we have gotten in an updated disk. Our computer did not have a code for these new meters, and we weren't made aware that we needed to have this code. So what we have gone back and we have isolated these 10 meters, made the corrections for what they should to the bills of what they should be. And until we can make sure we get everything done, we're going to manually read these 10 meters this coming Wednesday when we read meters. going to read them electronically. These 10, we're going to manually read and turn this reading in so that they will know the correct reading to put in. And when it picks up that extra, instead of saying, like, it should have been 8,000 gallons, it may say 88,000 gallons. And we have isolated these. We have taken some letters that the mayor and I, Charlika and Jade have sat down and made out. And I went around today to hand deliver these, and I delivered as many as I could. And some of the people weren't home. I'm going to try tomorrow to hand deliver the rest of them to explain to these people what the problem is and what their corrected bill is, amount should be.
In some cases that they had overpaid the amount.
Yes.
And in the cases where they were overpaid, they wrote a check out and put it in the envelope that, and when he's going around to see the people, he's giving them the difference between what they paid and what the city owed them.
Right.
We only have 10 meters like that.
Yes, ma'am. There was one lady that had a bill, I think for 3 months, it was like $1,700, where it should have been $235, I think. So, like I said, once we isolated these, we know what the problem is with these 10 meters. And like I said, we have taken steps to correct that, and we have taken steps to let the people know that have these 10 meters, that we have taken the steps to correct this and what steps we have taken. And we've got all this in these letters that we have sent out to them that I'm hand delivering.
So are we sure that the accuracy that we don't get on these other meters, are we sure that that is correct?
Yes. One meter, in fact, we actually went out to the house and took a 5 gallon bucket and filled it up a number of times and then checked the meter, got the reading on the meter, did this volume test and went back and checked the meter, and it gave us exactly what we poured up. I think it was 20 or 30 gallons that they did, and that's what the meter showed, that it had run that number of gallons through the meter when they did the test. And that's basically the same thing. Bigger cities have a way they can take the meter out and put it in a device. Some of them have a mobile device, some of them don't. Some of them have where they can break it and bring it back into the plant and do it. But the same thing, is what they're doing is they're putting it in there and they're running a known volume and making sure that meter is registering that much. And the same thing that we're doing, we're going out and filling the 5 gallon bucket up and doing the test that way.
But I've had more tip phone calls.
Well, and this time of year, you know, everybody uses more water. And when I say this, you're gonna say I'm crazy, but people bathe more than when it's hot weather. People wash their vehicles in the summertime, where they don't wash them in the wintertime, and different things like this.
Water their yard.
Water their flowers and stuff like this. And people just naturally use more water during the summertime than they do during the wintertime.
If I might add to what Philip is saying, under normal conditions, if we were sending the bills out here locally, it's probably something that we probably would have caught before now. But the bills are sent to Enhance, and we send the water usage to Enhance, and they in turn mail the bills out, you know, to the residents of the community.
When the meters were put in new, it would be, say it read, use, say at your house you use 600 gallons. Well, it would have read, with the way our system is set up now without that code in there, it would have read it as 6,000 gallons. At the next month, and which would not send up an alarm to anybody at 6,000 gallons on most residents. The next month, it may have went from 6 to 12. Here again, it still wouldn't throw up an alarm. The next month, it may have went from 12 to 29. Well, that's when alarm begins to come up. You know, and that's at that time is when we begin to catch this. Some of one or two of them we already knew about, and we were already taking steps on. We did not realize why, because of the code that we did that is not in our computer. That, and like I said, Charlie and I, we got on the phone with Badger Tech the other day and talked with them, and they explained to us that we didn't have the right code for these newer meters. And so Charlie had gotten with them, and they sent her an updated disk for the computer, so that she now has and will be installed before we read meters.
Well, Philip, the ones that overpaid, we're going to see they get their money back.
Yes, sir. If they overpaid, four, what did Charlika?
They had overpaid,
and the checks were in the letter that we sent back that we were hand-delivering. The check was in there with that to reimburse them for what they overpaid. If they had paid some and they still owed a little bit, the amount is in there what they owe and it's as compared to what it was showing before. So they can see if it was showing $300 and it should have been $35, it's in there in this letter that we're sending back. So that's just numbers I'm picking out of my head, for an example on that number. So, but if it's like that, then we've got that in that letter and it's broke down showing them, you know, what it was and what it should have been.
But this is not the same problem from 4 months ago.
No.
This is this month's problem.
Right. This was part of that problem started with that. Some of them had been in there for a while, and some of them were beginning to show up at that time. And here again, we did. And when my guys would go back out and read it, they would turn in the entire reading on that meter. And since then, I've got them to stop turning in the entire reading and turn in just for the 1,000 and up on the meter. So therefore, we know that the reading that they're turning in now is the correct reading for that meter. Because here again, if it's got 8 digits across there, their natural instinct at City Hall is to back up from their first three and start from there, which is what the computer's doing. And it's instead of backing up forwards on there and them and the computer both is only backing up three, and that's where the 1,000 should be. According to the old meters, that's where it is. But according to the new meters with that extra digit counting the tenth of a gallon on there, that's what throwing it off on those 10. So what I said, we have identified that problem and we have taken steps to correct that to make sure that doesn't happen again.
Excuse me?
May I ask a question?
Yes.
Can I ask?
Yes.
Okay. With the meters, on my notes, you said the old meters were 1,000 gallons that we as residents was using?
Yes, ma'am. Anything from 1,000 gallons up is what we registered.
Okay. Now, since you implanted new meters, we're going over 1,000?
No, ma'am. The meters go from 1 million to 100,000, 10,000, 1,000. And then it starts at 110 in a gallon and tenths. So our computer is actually picking up that 100 and showing that as 1,000 on these particular 10 meters. So therefore, like I said, with the new code that she has, it should correct that problem to where it would pick up to 1,000. Like I said, we only bill in at 1,000 gallons or up. If you use less than 2,000 gallons a month, you get a minimum bill. Anything over that, you would get your minimum bill plus so much, $1,000 thereafter.
Basically, what he was saying is it's reading the tenth place value as another thousand. So you had 600, but it's reading that other zero, instead of saying you only use, say, for example, 600 gallons, it's reading that tenth place value as another thousand. So instead of you used that 600, you use 6,000.
Right.
Which that's what's wrong. So you said how the newer bill, we didn't have the system to read that tenth place value.
That's right.
The old system was reading it as another thousand.
That's right.
Basically, our old water bill was not the correct amount either. So we got used to paying a bill that was set.
The old water bill is set at $1,000, and that's the way it reads, the way our computer reads. The older meters, it reads them at 1,000 gallons and above.
Now, bear in mind, we're only talking about 10.
Right.
10 meters.
We only have 10 of the new ones in the ground that is picking up this extra digit.
Okay, and that's for the whole city of Winston?
Only 10 that's in the ground, that's in the ground right now that's picking up that extra digit. Any others we put in will be the same as the ones we've got, so therefore, that's the reason we're getting this new code to put in our computer.
Okay, now how's it reading? They coming out to your house, or how are they reading?
They're read by computer. We put a computer on our truck, and we drive by. We don't have to get out. When I first started with the town, we got out and we manually went to each meter, raised the lid, and read it manually. But like I said, they're read by computer now, so all we do now is drive by. The MIU on the computer, on your meter, sends a signal out 7 times a second to that computer. So it's actually reading it 7 times before it actually logs it in.
Okay, now, you're saying it's picking up from the meter that's at the house. The meter at the house already has a chip in it that can transform to your vehicle where you're driving by?
Yes, ma'am.
And when did y'all install those?
Approximately 8 years ago.
8 years ago, okay. At that time, when y'all installed those meters 8 years ago, that you informed the public that this is digital, finna take place, and your water bill may in the future be higher than what it is now?
We didn't have any reason to assume that it would have been higher than it was then.
We went through, and we went through that system like most municipalities have. It eliminates a lot of manpower, like the old ways how we used to have to go out, and like, it took them like 3-4 days.
Rex, he used to be out there with us.
To go and read those meters. And this right here now, when they come up, it has a remote sensor on it, when they come up and it picks it up. Basically, what had happened, the new meters we got, is almost like when you got Windows 10 on your computer, but you had some programs that weren't compatible, and them programs would not work because it wouldn't work with Windows 10. So the computer system that we had, the software for these new meters, weren't compatible with our old software. The old software was reading that extra digit, saying that's not a tenth of a place value, that's another thousand. And that's what it was throwing to it. And so they done got it corrected. We're gonna be changing new meters out, but it's good we caught it now, where we got the new software to read it properly, how it's supposed to pick it up.
Okay, I understand that. Now, my next question, if you don't mind, are y'all going to inform the older citizen of what's taking place with the water system? Because a lot of people are still confused about what's really happening with their water bill. Are y'all gonna explain it to the older people that used to the old system, and their bills set at a certain rate, since their bills are higher now? So I'm asking the public, are y'all going to inform?
That is a great question, and I'm glad you brought it up, because we can start having daily, weekly gatherings at the Council on Aging. That's one way of reaching the elderly people. And we'll look for other ways to. That's a great idea. Yes, we will. And I appreciate that.
Thank you.
I hope I explained it well to everyone.
This stuff's good.
What day is the bill supposed to be pulled out of your checking account? What's the set day?
The tenth, or the closest business day to it.
To the tenth.
other questions?
I just don't think all of our problems with the water is in those 10 meters. I know where that question comes from. There's some bank drafts drawn, but on days that they weren't supposed to be drawn on. We get bills on the 9th that are due on the 13th. You know, but last month we got them on the 9th and they were due the 10th. And I mean, I'm speaking personally from K-Cup there. You know, that's what happened in my house. And that's what happened at some of my constituents' houses. You know, there doesn't seem to be any, okay, this is what's going to happen, and this is what day it's going to happen. We're used to getting water bills on the 1st or 2nd of each month, and then being due on the 10th, not on the 9th and being due on the 13th.
Well, with me being the only person at the City Hall that knows how to do the billing, it takes me longer to look through 570 pages to review the accounts before sending them out. And as far as the drafts, I don't want to send a draft through when someone has an $1,800 water bill. So I hold it until we can get as many fixed as possible, and then I send it through. I have to manually check all of these accounts and then send them back out to get reread if I think there's an error with it. And I have to adjust and fix it, and then I have to do it, along with fixing your financials and getting your reports together and getting your invoices and payroll. So that's why it's taking longer, because I'm the only one. I have three new staff members that don't know how to do anything.
Are you going to be able to train them?
I'm trying. It's hard to train, when I have to do all of this. You know, we stay after hours sometimes, but it's only one thing.
But most people can, if they apply for a job, you know, they can be trained. And if they've been there more than 2 weeks, they ought to know how to help you storm charter. And you can't do it all. You cannot. But I make a motion that we put this financial report over on Wednesday's meeting, simply because I haven't had adequate time to review it since I was told it was going to be.
Second. Put that on the continued meeting.
You're not trying to correct it.
Huh?
You're not trying to fix it.
Yeah.
What time?
What I'd like to do tonight, a little bit different what we talked about, go ahead and adopt the sales tax renewal tonight. I just emailed y'all the resolution. Everybody should have a copy. It was prepared by our bonding attorney. We need to amend the agenda because of typographical errors. Number 5 needs to be amended to say adoption of resolution number 160803 instead of that ordinance number. And you have, each one of y'all have a copy on your email of the resolution. I just sent it to you. And if we could adopt it tonight, the only thing we'll have to continue over will be number 6 and number 17 for Wednesday. This is going to just be a continuation meeting. We'll call an adjourned meeting and recess meeting, and we want to start it up again.
Is there a deadline or something?
I make a motion.
It's kind of time sensitive. I think we could do it to Craig, but I don't want to take a chance. The bonding attorney wants to adopt it tonight. So we've done the announcement in June. Marcy, y'all published a notice right after that, and it stated we're going to take it up tonight.
I make a motion to amend the agenda.
Properly moved.
Second.
Do we have a second? A second, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Our director reflect that.
We need to adopt the resolution.
I make a motion to adopt resolution number 16803, calling for a special renewal.
For the sale tax.
Calling for.
Just say calling for the half percent sale.
Ordering and calling a special election to be held. It should be renewal. Right? It's not a special election.
But it is a special election.
It's a special election.
It is a special election.
It's a special election, our renewal.
For the sale tax. The way Wes wanted to do is a special, call for a special election for sales tax renewal.
Yeah, renewal.
I'm gonna bring a resolution to you and your legal tomorrow, so y'all can sign it, Mayor.
Second, Mayor.
I'll have one.
Properly moved and second.
I need to make a correction to it. Yeah. Make a motion and second.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Aye.
One opposed.
And the meeting is at what time, Wednesday?
Six o'clock.
Yeah, need to be motion to adjourn until.
You want to announce that we're going to adjourn?
We need to adjourn.
Announce that we're going to adjourn until Wednesday at six.
We need to.
We will continue the meeting until Wednesday at 6 o'clock.
Yes.
Okay.
Correct.
Do I need a motion for that?
And you want to state is to take up ordinance number 983, the way on water rate increase.
To take up, adopt ordinance number 983.
Water rate. We have a motion and second and need a vote.
Continue?
Yeah, motion to continue the meeting. Craig and then Rick second. All in favor?
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.